Greetings, dear viewers. Welcome, one and all, from your turkey and your shopping hangovers, and this is the LTA Movie Club, where we come together to watch a new movie every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. The easiest legal way to watch movies on Movie Club is to go to netflix.com/PhillyD. Follow that URL to Boundless Wonder, and you get a free 1 month trial of Netflix streaming movies. Today's picture is A Knight's Tale,
which is described as a youthful squire befriends an aspiring writer and persuades him to forge documents that will pass the squire off as a bona fide knight. The erstwhile squire finds romance and enters jousting competitions, all to the beat of contemporary pop tunes. Why, yes, Paul Bettany did contract laryngitis during the shoot from all that shouting. Ah, Knight's Tale. I remember in 2001, you were one of the precious few movies that summer that didn't completely suck balls. 10 years on, I enjoy Knight's Tale much more than I expected to. It's a lot of fun, the cast has great chemistry, it's got a lot of heart, a lot of charm, everything you could ask for. A Knight's Tale comes to us courtesy of one Brian Helgeland, at a point in his career when he had become a very successful Hollywood screenwriter, and was now trying his hand at directing. What this movie is most known for, apart from starring the late great Heath Ledger, and featuring Paul Bettany's pasty white buttocks, is a soundtrack packed full of classic rock hits against a medieval backdrop. The opening scenes where the tournament crowd is rocking out to Queen. That's the film telling the audience in big bold letters, "Do not take this too seriously, it is not that kind of movie." It really does help the film stand out rather than sinking into just another run-of-the-mill underdog sports movie. Could have done without the Golden Years dance number. It's an odd choice of song, and the movie was really dragging by that point. I guess the writer wanted to show that if William really wanted to do the whole jousting thing, he was gonna have to partake in all the lame nobleman stuff too. The film starts strong, it finishes strong, the middle gets pretty muddled. It lacks focus. Some scenes run too long, a couple don't really need to be in there at all. I blame whoever designed Shannon Sossaman's horrible costumes for all of it. Oh yeah, they're that bad. A lot of people dislike the bit where Jocelyn tells William to lose a few rounds to prove that he loves her. I can kinda understand it. She doesn't want him turning into every other douchebag who's trying to get in her skirt, but there was no reason for her to let it go on as long as it did. That was just mean. Let him take one hit and then rush over there and say, "Okay, you don't need to lose for me anymore, I believe you." I did really like the subplot with the Black Prince played by James Purefoy. It's a nice side story that I don't think a lesser screenwriter would have even thought of. And it had a great payoff at the end. Well, that's all for me. Don't forget to leave your comments down in my pantaloons, along with suggestions and recommendations for what the Movie Club should watch next. Your homework for Wednesday is to watch Scarface. And oh yeah,
what did you think, Movie Club?